Umar ibn al-Khattab used to challenge Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. That's the beauty of the Sahaba. They didn't look to others and say, oh, that's okay, he's a sheikh. They were inspired by one another. They envied one another in a good way. They أُولَٰئِكَ يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ They used to rush for the good deeds. They used to compete with one another for good deeds. So Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu says, look, I'm able to beat everyone else, but I can't beat Abu Bakr. And he said, one day I decided, today I'm going to beat Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So what did he do? He came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with half of everything that he owned. He said, Ya Rasulullah, here it is. For the sake of Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What did you leave for your family, O Umar? I left half of everything I own. MashaAllah, Ahsant, Ya Umar, you've done well, O Umar, you've done good. All of us can look at Umar radiallahu anhu and say, that was a great move. Half of everything you own. Then comes Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Umar thought he won. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu didn't even know what Umar did. It's not like Abu Bakr said, oh yeah, fine, I'm going to give everything I own. Abu Bakr came organically and gave everything to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, what have you left for your family? Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu gave it all. And subhanAllah, a lot of times we think, well, that means we should all give it all. You know that if you study the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he didn't allow any other sahabi to do that? No companion was allowed to do that except for Abu Bakr. Ka'b ibn Malik radiallahu anhu and the famous story of his tawbah, of his repentance, where he was so happy and he was one of the richest men in Medina. He was so happy when Allah accepted his repentance that Ka'b radiallahu anhu gave everything. He even took off the thawb that he was wearing and gave it to the one that gave him the news that Allah accepted your repentance. And he comes to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and says, I'm giving all of my wealth for the sake of Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, أَمْسِكْ عَلَيْكَ بَعْضَ الْمَنْ Hold on to some of your wealth. And Rasulullah ﷺ is telling him, don't give it all. Ka'b radiallahu anhu is saying, fine, I'll keep some of what came from the spoils of Uhud. But everything else is for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet ﷺ didn't let him give it all. Likewise, Abu Talha, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ You will not achieve true righteousness or the reward of righteousness being al-Jannah until you spend from that which you love. Abu Talha had the gardens of Bayruha, which today if you go to Medina, the Prophet ﷺ used to relax in that garden. People used to enjoy that garden right in front of the masjid. They used to relax in that beautiful garden. It was his best garden. Palm trees, springs, everything. And Abu Talha heard that verse. And he says to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he comes to him and he says, I thought of hatta tunfiqu mimma tuhibbun till you spend from that which you love. Ya Rasulullah, here is Bayruha for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm giving the entire garden away. And you know what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says to him? Ara an taj'alaha fil aqrabin. I think you should save it for your family members, for your kin. And his intention was still solid. He had it inside of him, I want to give it all, but the Prophet ﷺ told him no. Why Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu? Why was Abu Bakr allowed to give it all? Because the Prophet ﷺ knows Abu Bakr will come and give it all, and he's not going to go home and go, oh my God, what have I done? And his wife is not going to say to him, what? You gave it all away? No, Abu Bakr will give it all, then he'll go and he'll work in the market until he earns enough to give again. That was the attitude of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Kana sabbaqan li kulli khayr. As Ali radiallahu anhu says about him, that if you thought about good, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu already did it. When you have a good idea, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu already superseded all of the Sahaba in doing it. And so Umar radiallahu anhu says later on, when Abu Bakr is Khalifa, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu went to the outskirts of Medina where there were some elder people that weren't being served, that couldn't be tended to. And so he goes and he does this secretly for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first door he knocks on the outskirts of Medina, the old woman says, someone has already come. He says, who's already come here? Someone's already been here. And so Umar radiallahu anhu demands to know, and she's not giving away the identity. Umar radiallahu anhu goes and hides behind her house, waits to see who it is. And here comes the Khalifa, the first non-prophet Khalifa, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. the first non-infallible Khalifa, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, with everything on his plate, from people leaving Islam, people withholding their zakah, people celebrating the death of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, coming out to these old elderly people on the sides to serve them. And Umar radiallahu anhu cries and he says, لَقَدْ أَتْعَبْتَ مَنْ جَاءَ مِنْ بَعْدِكَ. You have exhausted everyone that comes after you, O Abu Bakr. And he said, by Allah, I've never taken a path of good except that I found Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu already traveled it.